at question 29 and it's asking us to use the leading coefficient test to determine the end behavior of the polynomial function. We are given the function f of x is equal to negative 3x fourth plus 4x cubed minus 5x squared minus 4x minus 1. Now the first step you want to take with a polynomial function when determining the leading coefficient is you want to make sure that your function is arranged from left to right with the equal sign on the left, with the highest exponent on the far left-hand side to the least greatest exponent. Next, to determine the end behavior, you're going to follow a few simple steps depending on your n, which is your exponent. So with a leading coefficient, you always want to look at your leading coefficient, whether it's positive or negative, and your n, which is your exponent. So when your n is even, you're going to follow one of two rules. If your leading coefficient is positive, your graph will be going up, left, into the left and right-hand corners. If your leading coefficient is negative, it's going to be dropping in both sides of the graph. Now, if your n is odd, there's a few extra steps to take. If your leading coefficient is positive and your exponent n is odd, your graph is going to drop on the left-hand side and rise in the right-hand side. If your leading coefficient is negative when your n exponent is odd, your graph is going to be rising in the left-hand corner and falling in the right-hand corner. Now looking at our function, we can see that our leading coefficient is arranged properly from the highest exponent ranking on the left and the lowest exponent ranking on the right. So we know that our leading coefficient is going to be negative 3x fourth. Already looking at this, let's look at our n, which is our exponent. We can see that our n is even. It's 4. So we're going to be looking at this set of rules, meaning our graph will be going up in both the left-hand side and the right-hand side of the graph. Now let's look at our leading coefficient. We can see our leading coefficient is negative, so we know we're going to be looking at rule 2. This means our leading coefficient is going to be dropping in both the left-hand side and the right-hand side of the graph. So to determine the end behavior, to write that, you would say that your graph is going to fall to the left and it's going to fall to the right. So that will be your final answer using the leading coefficient test. As always, like and subscribe below and comment if you have any questions.